Hello students, once again welcome back in my class. In my previous video, that is part 2 of the chapter, I taught you about northern plains of India, and today I will tell you about different river basins of northern plains. So the northern plains are divided into three river basins, namely the Satluj river basin, the Ganga river basin and the Brahmaputra river basin. So the first one is the Satluj river basin, which lies in the west side of India. The river Satluj flows towards southeast direction and then it joins Indus river in Pakistan, and then it flows into the Arabian Sea. And now the states which come under this basin is Punjab and Haryana, which gets watered by this basin. Since there is lot of water and the soil here is very fertile, so the main occupation of the people is farming, and the main crops grown here are wheat, rice, cotton, millet, sugarcane, etc. Children, do you know which is the largest dam in India? It is the Bhakra Nangal Dam, which is built across this river Satluj. So now the question comes, what is dam? A dam is a barrier built across the river to hold water back from flowing, means to stop the flow of water the dam is made. So the dam provides water for irrigation and produces electricity, and to produce this electricity using water is called hydroelectricity, as the word hydro comes from water. See, here is a picture of the Bhakra Nangal Dam, and you can see very clearly there is a barrier or a big wall of stones to stop the flow of water. The second river basin is the Ganga river basin, and the river Ganga is the most important river in India, which lies in the middle of the northern plains. Students, you must have heard about river Ganga, as it is the holy river of Hindus, and it originates from Gangotri glacier in the Himalaya mountains. Next is the river Yamuna, which is main tributary of river Ganga, and the Yamuna originates from Yamunotri glacier, and where they meet is called Sangam. Clear? Now some tributaries of Ganga are Ghagra, Gandak, Gomti and Kosi, which joins Ganga basin from the east side. Now after the Ganga enters West Bengal, it gets divided into two streams. One stream flows into West Bengal where it is called River Hooghly, and the other flows into Bangladesh where it is called River Padma. Okay, now when these rivers flow, they carry sediments and silts which gets deposited. Children, do you know how they deposit? They deposit in the form of triangular islands at the mouth of the river, and then these are known as the delta. And due to this, many streams are formed, which is known as distributaries. So when the Ganga and the Brahmaputra rivers join together, they form the world's largest delta, which is known as the Sundarban Delta. Another point to be noted here is that as this area is very fertile and here lots of crops can be grown, and because of that this basin has another name, that is the food bowl of India. Okay, so by now you must be clear that why the Ganga river is so important river in India. Now the last basin is the Brahmaputra river basin, which lies in the eastern part of the northern plains, and the Brahmaputra river rises in Tibet where it is called Tsangpo, and then it enters India through Arunachal Pradesh, and then it flows through the narrow valleys, as you can see, through Assam. And this region gets heavy rainfall, and because of that, river Brahmaputra sometimes causes floods also. This basin is rich in minerals also. So I hope you had a good session of chapter the Northern Mountains and Northern Plains, and I hope you all are taking good care of yourself.